The eastern half of Idaho's Snake River Plain is coated with numerous dark black lava flows which starkly contrast with the surrounding landscape. The most famous of these sub-regions is the Craters of the Moon Volcanic Complex, where a minimum of 15 volcanic eruptions occurred between 15,100 and 2,100 years ago, covering a grand total of 618 square miles. When these volcanoes erupted, it produced a sight similar to what was witnessed during each of the last three summers at Iceland's Vigridalsvík volcano. Yet, while Craters of the Moon is the largest complex, there are also three other volcanoes considered to be active or potentially active, along with three lesser-known dormant volcanoes, including the Three Buttes complex, two of which are composed out of highly viscous rhyolite lava domes, and the explosively formed Menon Buttes, which once produced an explosive eruption a quarter of the size of the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Yet, beyond these features, there are hundreds of other volcanic vents unrelated to a specific volcanic field, few of which are well known. These include eroded cinder cones, former shield volcanoes, pit craters which are also referred to as collapse craters, lava fields, and fissure vents. As a whole, the eastern Snake River Plain represents an area of crust where the Yellowstone Hotspot once progressed through millions of years ago, which, during that time period, several voluminous explosive caldera-forming eruptions occurred. Because of this activity, the entire path the hotspot took was greatly weakened, making future volcanic eruptions more likely. While the modern Yellowstone Hotspot is currently centered underneath Yellowstone Lake in Wyoming, it still manages to cause volcanic eruptions far away from its center via its mantle plume trail, which trends opposite the current movement of the North American plate. While this plume trail does not contain as much molten rock as the plume center underneath the Yellowstone volcano, it still occasionally causes molten rock, typically of a basaltic composition, to intrude into the crust. Areas where repeated intrusions occurred in a small area subsequently became rift zones which slowly spread apart, allowing for additional intrusions to occur along the same trend, as they represented a path of least resistance in the crust. Currently, 10 such rift zones exist in the eastern Snake River Plain, the most famous of which is Idaho's Great Rift Zone, which includes multiple vents from both the Craters of the Moon and Wapi lava fields. While some vents can sometimes perfectly erupt along the exact center of the rift zone, sometimes this does not occur. As a result, the weakness generated by a rift zone appears to expand outwards, allowing for eruptions technically related to the rift zone to occur within 7 miles of the rift zone's central axis, with closer eruptions to the center being more common. To understand what this looks like, I have overlaid the 10 Idaho rift zones in yellow along with their 7-mile extension in each direction. Altogether, these rift zones represent about 50% of the area where volcanic eruptions are theoretically possible in the Snake River Plain, but contain 93% of its vents. In the Snake River Plain, ancient cinder cones formed from moderately explosive eruptions are the easiest feature to spot, as they not only represent a localized high point, but have a steeper slope of 15 to 35 degrees and a central crater. One such example is a 34,000-year-old sand butte vent. If we look to the north and south of Sand Butte, we will see a north-to-south trending extension of what was once a single erupting fissure vent. This fissure vent initially erupted along its entirety, as shown by the uniform slopes on its east and west sides, before a single small section of the fissure became dominant, forming a cinder cone. Fissure vents are recognizable based on what appears to be a singular long line, sometimes with sections buried by lava that once erupted at the same time, instead of occurring from a somewhat circular central crater. Pit craters represent upward migrating void spaces that once represented where at-depth magma once existed, which can take thousands of years to reach the surface. These features are identifiable by their crater floor completely covered with debris and wall slopes within the pit crater of more than 55 degrees. Meanwhile, shield volcanoes often contain a pit-like crater at their summit, but the crater floors of these features are rarely covered in loose debris. Shield volcanoes in the Snake River Plain are best identifiable by their large size, generally being wider than 3.5 miles and containing a slope under 10 degrees, often under 5 degrees. One example of a shield volcano is Crater Butte, which is 3.25 miles north of the town of Dietrich and contains a nearly 1-mile-long and 276-foot-deep summit crater. This vent formed approximately 150,000 years ago during a completely effusive eruption, probably several months in length, that sent lava flows up to 7 miles away, covering a grand total of 38.6 square miles. A second vent I am highlighting involves a lava flow which begins a mile east of the town of Richfield. Heading north, this same lava flow contains numerous raised and lowered sections, which occur alongside numerous cracks. The raised features are referred to as lava rise plateaus, while the lowered features are referred to as inflation pits. Simply put, both of these structures formed in response to the viscosity of the lava flow, the way the lava was being fed, and interaction with underlying terrain. This caused what used to be a raised patch of ground to become lower and for a lower section of ground to become higher once the eruption ended and lava solidified. Lava east of Richfield formed due to an eruption 430,000 years ago, originating from a cinder cone 16 miles to the north-northeast. This cinder cone is unnamed but produced a mildly explosive eruption which probably lasted more than a year, leading to 83.1 square miles being covered in a layer of basaltic lava. I want to note that none of these specific vents will erupt again as they are monogenetic, meaning they are extinct, but future eruptions are likely to occur again in the general area of the Snake River Plain. Here is a quick overview of 17 other features with their vent type and approximate age. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.